hello everyone. This is Ashwini Abhay. Today we will discuss how to write a menu-driven program. Okay, so up till now we finished with all the string operations. Now we will write a combined program which will be menu-driven. Now, what will be the changes in our program? So, after declaring all the variables, we will start with the menu-driven. Now, this operation we have to perform, we will display the menu for user. Suppose, first one is access the first string. So, access the first string. Okay? Then, next will be again slash n. Second will be what? Display first string. Okay? Then next one is, next operation is what? Slash n. Third one is length of suppose first string. Next slash n. Suppose fourth one is length of, or suppose we will directly consider fourth one is copy. Here I have list of operations. So copy, after copy we discuss the reverse operation. So after copy slash n, fifth one will be a reverse slash n. Six, after reverse we discuss the compare operation, comparison of two strings, slash n. Seventh operation is a span window, slash n. Eighth operation is substring, slash n. Nine is suppose. Okay. Now, after displaying all these menu, we have to ask the user that which operation we have to perform. So, for that purpose, we have to give the message that enter your choice. So, which operation we have to perform. So, the end is the simple. Now, if user want to perform reverse operation, it will enter as what? 5. Palindrome 7. Meaning, user will enter the 1, 2, 3, 4 up to the 9. Right? So, choice of the user will be a integer. So, that's why we declare one variable C here, whose data type is what? Integer. Now, user having the choice either one of the 1, 2, 3 up to the 9. Any one of the choice user can enter. Right now we have to check multiple conditions. This condition whether user has entered 1, whether user has entered 4, any one of them. So, for multiple condition checking, we are use one decision making step name, which is the switch. What is the use of switch? Switch is used to check multiple condition but on single variable. So right now our single variable is what? C. And that variable is having multiple values. Switch C. So this one is the opening and closing of switch. So, before going for the switch statement, we have to accept the value of here. So, how you will accept? Can F. Now, can F. What is here? Here is an integer value. So, percent D and this percent D. After accepting the value, where we have to store in the CSS. So, switch we have applied on one variable, which is here. So depending value of the depending on the value which is user entered by the user, we will perform the different operation. So case 1 will write again how many cases you have to write three. So K, two, three. Okay, so this is for P and this is S. So case one, after case one we are having one more case. Case number will be 2. Then case 4. Case 5. Case number 6. Case 7. Case 8. Then how many cases? 8. Okay, now what is this operation we have to perform in case 1? We have to accept the first string. So we already write how to accept the string. So we will directly copy this code now inside case 1. So what will be the case 1? Case 1 is enter this string and we have to accept that string. After accepting, we are storing into the string variable. Now, second is what? Display first string. So, how you will display the string? By using printf. So, we display the string. Write the code of displaying the string in case 2. Now, third operation is what? Length of the first string. So, we write the code. Which code? Length. So for calculating the length, what we are doing? We are start the scanning from this location, 0th location up to the null. Right? So we are start scanning from 0th location up to the null and after that we are incrementing our continuously. Okay? So see. For length calculation, we start from 0 up to the string 1 is not null, we are increment I. And continuously we are incrementing length. And here our length is declared as an integer and we are initialized as a 0. So this length is over. Now after that, fourth case is copy. We already finished with the copy code. Suppose control C, control S, control. Now in copy, how you will copy the one string into another string? We have to start the copy from which location? 0th character, right? Up to the null. So how you will write the for I equal to 0 till null character. So how we will write? Till str1 of I is not equal to null. Okay. So what we will do? We will write string 1 of I is going to store into the string 2 of I. Means character which is present at ith location in string 1 we are going to copy into the again ith location but in string 2. Okay? And every string is end with the null character. So we manually write string 2 of I as a null because we are not copying the null character into the string 2. And we are finally printed as copying string 2. Okay? So copy is over. Then next function is reverse. Reverse we already discussed. Reverse string. Case number 5. So in reverse function, reverse is comment. We have to do in reverse function. first function, we have to first, again we have to copy this string from one string to another string, but in reverse order. So first we will start the scanning your first string from 0th location up to the null. So using this for loop, your eye will point to the null character. So whether we have to copy the null character? No. We have to start the copy the character from the character which is present before the null. So we will increment I by 1. After that, we have to start the copying into the string 2. So we will start from the character which is present before the null, but where? From 0th location. Okay? So j equal to 0. Here again, I is used for string 1 and j is used for string 2. What will be the termination condition? Termination condition will be I should be greater than or equal to 0. And continuously what we are doing? We are copying string 1 into the string 2. And manually we will write that string 2 of j is equal to null and we will print the reverse string. Okay? Now next function is compare. Compare. For comparison, we require the two strings, so we accept the two string, second string, and then we write the comparison. So, case number 6, we will remove the comment, okay. Enter the second string, we already accept the first string, now we will accept the second string, we will print that second string, then start the comparison from first character. If any one of the characters is not matching, then what we are doing? We are leaving flag as 1. So depending on the value of the flag, we are displaying the result. So initially we have declared one flag, okay? And the value of flag we set as 1, 0. So if character is not matching, then the value of flag becomes what? 1. So depending on the value of flag, so if value of flag is 0, so strings are not equal. But if value of flag is not 0, then value of flag is 0, meaning is strings are equal. Else strings are not equal. Okay? So this means should be compare also. Next we are having palindrome. So for palindrome, again we require the second string, so control D. Now before starting the palindrome we require the second string, so again we will accept the second string in case 7, enter the second string. We are accepting second string, we are printing the second string. Then here we are having some examples. Now remove the comment. For again we have to start from this. Now in palindrome we are first, in palindrome what we are doing, we are accepting the first string, then we are accepting the second string, then we are reverse that string, okay, by using for loop, and then we are start the comparison of between your first original string which is in string 1 and reverse string is in string 2. Okay? Then here we are printing our reverse string and here you see comparison between your string 1 and string 2. Either you can write in this way or directly before calling palindrome operation, what you will do? You will call to reverse menu and then call to palindrome. Okay? So we will do in both the ways. So right now we will write in our Excel code. Again, depending on the value of the flag, initially value of flag is 0, meaning is what? String is palindrome. Otherwise string is not palindrome. Same And last operation is a substitute. Logic is what? If both the characters, string 1 and string 2 character is matching, then we are implementing both the location counters. So I is used for string 1 and J is used for string 2. If both are matching, we are implementing. After implementing J, that we are checking whether your string 2 is finished. If string 2 is finished, meaning is what? That is, string 2 is a part of your first string. So we are incrementing count by 1. Means that string is present at least one time. And for again checking whether it is present for second time, we are initializing J to 0. So we are again restart the scanning from 0 time. But if it is not matching, then what we are doing? We are simply incrementing the I and we are reinitializing the J. Now depending on the count variable, if count value is 0, meaning is what? It is not the part of your string. So it is a not substring. Else it is a substring and we are printing how many times it is printed. Okay? So we will save this, click on execute, compile and run. Now it is having some errors, so we will just remove that. Save. Okay? So it is showing some errors. First, enter the first string. Suppose string is absent. See, what is the problem? We perform what? This operation, first operation. So, what is the value of CS? 1. Switch 1. Well, which case it will execute? Case 1. It will print as what? Enter the first string and it is displaying the. Sorry, it will accept the first string and it will store into the string 1. Now, if I will remove this break statement, what it will do? Save, click on execute, compile and run. Again, first, suppose this one is your string, C. After that, it is executed with statement, this string is. Meaning is what? If you will not return a break, it will start the executing sequentially. So, we are printing this statement, we are accepting this string and finally, next is what? Next statement is what? The string is. So, it will print your this. Again, if I will remove this, what it will do? It will execute next case. Next case is what? Case 3, it will print the length of this string. Okay? So, first, meaning, once user give the value of choice as what? 1. Then also it will accept this string, display this string, again it will calculate the length of this string. So what we have to do? Given after accepting this string, it has to again accept the choice from the user. See, after accepting this string, we have to calculate either length, copy, reverse, any one of the operations we have to perform on the string. So what we have to do? We have to repeat this task again and again. So to repeat anything, we are having some loop statement. So here we will use do while. What is the use of do while? Do while at least execute once and it will execute the condition afterwards. Okay, so do while. While will be what? Choice should not be equal to your exit. Okay, so if you want to terminate your program, we have to enter as what? 9 for the exit. So save again. Execute. See the difference. After choice 1, it will accept this thing. Again, it will display the menu that now what will be your next operation. Suppose next operation is display. So see, here it is displaying this thing. The string is this one. Now, third, length of this string is what? 6. Fourth, if you want to perform the copying, so after copying, you will get the message as well, the copied string is this one. Now, we have to perform reverse operation, 6-1. Reverse is what? GFS, see, SGDHSG, okay? Now, next one is what? Compare. Now, which string we have to compare, right? Now, if I am saying that I want to compare this string with the original string, so meaning is what? String is not equal, right? Now, again, if I will accept my first string as a string, and if I will compare this with 6 is what? A string. Now, strings are not equal, right? Now, after accepting second string as a string, then also it is showing that what strings are not equal. So, what is the problem? So, first we will terminate our program. Okay? Now, problem is what? See the comparison code. In comparison, what we are doing? We are accepting this string and then what we are doing? We are comparing. And depending on the value of this flag, we are displaying the result. This flag variable we have used in reverse function also. This function. We are using some different function. Okay? So, before calling any one of these functions which are depend on your value of this flag, we have to set the value of flag as what? 0. Because then we declare the flag and we initialize with the 0, but initialization of the variable is done only once. Okay? Once. So, before calling any one of the function or any one of the case which is depend on this flag, we have to reset the value of the flag. So, here also in paragraph case number 7, we will set the value of flag as a 0. Now, first choice, now we have to compare this one. For comparison, second string is again a string. Now it is showing as what? Strings are equal. Okay? After comparison, if we are having 7, 7 is what we have to check whether string is palindrome or not. So, for palindrome, it will accept the input, suppose. Okay, so the second string is madam, reverse string is this, string is not palindrome. Okay, right. See the code for the palindrome. What we write in palindrome? In palindrome, what we are doing there, we are having, already we are having the string 1. We have to reverse that string and we have to store into string 2. So, for palindrome, we are not required the second. So, we will remove that code. So, we are having string 1 as the original string. We will reverse that string and we will store into this string 2. We will manually write none, then we will directly print reverse string D and then we will compare that. Okay? So again, save, compile and execute. Now, access first string is suppose this one. Now, palindrome 7. String is not palindrome. Right? Now, again, if I will access next string as a madam and check the palindrome. String is a palindrome. So you have to check each and every option. Palindrome, not palindrome. Equal, not equal. Okay? Now, next is suppose x1. Now, x1 is what? It is a found. Okay? Again, wait. See the substring code. In substring code, we require the second string. Okay? So, we have to access the second string which we have to check into first string. So, case number, we have accepted. Now, save, execute, compile and run. Now, first, now, string, hamare, again, suppose, string. Okay? Now, Next option is substring A. Which string we have to say? Okay? String. It is a part of your string and it is found how many times? 2 times. Now, if I will again call a substring function and second string, if I will give AS, okay? Now, it is showing as what? Now, problem is what? It is not a substring. Then also it is showing as what? It is a substring found 2 times. Why? Because same problem. We have initialized the count variable at the beginning of your program and this initialization is done only once. Okay? So, previous value of count is what? 2. So, that's why it is showing as what? It is present 2 times. Okay? So, we will again compile and run. So we have made the value of count as 0. So click on execute, compile, run. Now again accept for string, suppose now for substring it will give the input as ASSWO. So it is showing as what? Not a sub. Okay? Next. 9 is for exit. Now, what will be the problem if user will enter a choice apart from 1 to 9. Suppose if I will enter 56. Again, it is showing the message. Okay? So, to avoid that, what we will do? We will write one default case. Default will be what? Inside this. Okay? So, default. In default, what we will write? Printf flat n wrong choice we enter the choice. Okay? Then, again say click on execute, compile and now. If I will enter any choice, suppose 11, what it is saying? Wrong choice, re-enter this. Okay? Any choice we give will this. Okay? 9 for this. Okay, thank you.